Good evening, I'm back. I'm your host, Jack Remington of the Jack Remington Political Analyst Channel. Today's video is a good one. I'm always bashing the Associated Press because they like to call elections and push certain things, deny certain things. However, this time they got something right. The title reads, quote, Arizona woman admits guilt in ballot collection scheme, end quote. An Arizona woman accused of illegally collecting early ballots in a 2020 primary election pleaded guilty Thursday in an agreement with state prosecutors that saw the more serious forgery and conspiracy charges dismissed and eliminated any potential for a lengthy prison sentence. So in other words, she pled her way out of this. So let's see what the damage is here and let's see what the cause and effect here. Guillermina Fuentes, she's 66 years old, could get probation for running what Arizona Attorney General Office investigators said was a sophisticated operation using her status as a well-known Democratic operative in the border city of San Luis to persuade voters to let her gather in, and in some cases fill out their ballots. This was done in the Loretta Sanchez versus Bob Dornan Orange County case back in 1996. So I had the video up on YouTube. They took it, they just whooped, bashed it, vanished it, right, with no explanation. I'm going to have to rework that video and I'll put that back up here. Prosecutors were apparently unable to prove the most serious charges, dropping three felony counts alleging that Fuentes filled out one voter's ballot and forged signatures on some of the four ballots she illegally returned for people who were not family members. Republicans have rallied around the possibility of widespread voting fraud in the 2020 election, where former President Donald Trump was defeated, have pointed to the charges against Fuentes as part of a broader pattern in battleground states. But there's no sign her illegal ballot collection went beyond the small-town politics Fuentes was involved in. Fuentes and a second woman were indicted in December 2020 on one count of ballot abuse, a practice commonly known as, quote, ballot harvesting, end quote, that was made illegal under a 2016 state law. The conspiracy, forgery, and additional ballot abuse charge against Fuentes were added last October. Fuentes said very little during the change of plea hearing in southwestern Arizona's Yuma County on Thursday, just acknowledging the judge's questions with a, quote, yes, end quote, as he asked whether she had read and understood the plea agreement. Fuentes, a former San Luis mayor who serves as an elected board member of the Gadsden Elementary School District of San Luis, could be sentenced to up to 2 years in prison, but that will require a judge to find aggravating circumstances. The plea agreement leaves an actual sentence up to a judge who could give her probation, home confinement, and a hefty fine for her admission to illegally collecting and returning four voted ballots. In other words, they were the ones that they actually counted as illegally harvested ballots that she forged their names. She put their names on for these people. That's illegal in most states. But that's changing because Democrats control the state legislatures of these Democratic states and they're wiping away signature matching and everything. Now you know why they don't want the signature matching. Now you know why Jeff Bezos fought it when they were trying to unionize against Amazon and he wanted to strike out the signature matching. Jeff Bezos, that guy, was the richest person for about 3 years until Elon Musk took over. And in Gavin Newsom's recall, if you don't want you to remember, I got to work that election thing. I made some Gavin Newsom money. I made $1,500 take-home money for those week of training and the 4 or 5, 6, whatever it was for the recall. I made bank off of Gavin Newsom, so I shouldn't complain. I'm not complaining. I'm bragging. But I want to say here is that Gavin Newsom also tried to do away with the signature matching during his recall. But they bitched about it when Donald Trump beat Hillary Clinton in 2016. They bitched about it when Joe Biden allegedly beat Donald Trump in 2020. Hey, you can't have it both ways, Democrats, but they've been getting both ways because people won't stop them. And that's why I put these videos up, and I'm bringing back the voter fraud videos. I'm bringing them back. Okay. Sentencing was set for June 30th. She will lose her voting rights and must give up elected office. Attorney Ann Chapman said in an email Thursday that she had no comment on the charges against her client. But she slammed Arizona's ballot collection law, saying it impedes minority voters who have historically relied on others to help them vote. She said, quote, this prosecution shows that the law is part of the ongoing anti-democratic statewide and national voter suppression efforts, end quote. Always crying f***ing blues because they for this and that. So we're supposed to stop our world because these people can't get to the polls and these people don't know how to vote. They can't see a face and hit the touch screen. So we got to stop our world and let them take over because they can't function, okay? That's what they're telling us. The Attorney General's Office's investigation records obtained by the Associated Press through a public records request show that fewer than a dozen ballots could be linked to Fuentes, not enough to make a difference in all but the tightest local races. And some of the races were decided by 10 or less votes. Don't tell me these 10 or 12 or 20 votes or 100 votes can't sway an election. It happened in Minnesota with that guy that got Al Franken. The Office of Attorney General Mark Brnovich, a Republican seeking his party's U.S. Senate nomination, provided the records after delays of more than 15 months. Delays of 15 months, that's not a misspeak here. It is the only case ever brought by the Attorney General under the 2016, quote, ballot harvesting, end quote, law, which was upheld by the U.S. Supreme Court last year. Investigators wrote that it appeared Fuentes used her position as a powerful figure in the heavily Mexican-American community to get people to give her and others their ballots to return to the polls. Fuentes and her co-defendants were seen with several mail-in envelopes outside the Cultural Center in San Luis the day of the 2020 primary election, the reports show. The ballots were taken inside and dropped in a ballot box. She was videotaped by a write-in candidate who called Yuma County Sheriff. The report said the video showed her marking at least one ballot, but that charge was among those dropped. An investigation was launched that day, and about 50 ballots checked for fingerprints, which were inconclusive. That's why in Dinesh D'Souza's film, The 20 Mules, it shows the grainy video of the guys wearing blue latex gloves. Do away the fingerprints. I'm telling you, the Democrats are 2 to 3 to 4 to 5 steps ahead of the Republicans and everyone else in this country when it comes to voter fraud, voter registration, illegal harvesting, ballot harvesting, illegal voters, illegal everything. And the trick is, they know if they can just get people registered, that's half the battle for them. It's hard for watchdogs like us to catch them with the registrations. We can't be in every center every day, 24/7, watching them bring their busloads. Like I called the busload of people here in Ventura County. The day these kids turn 18 years old, the van opens out, the lady opens the door, and they come rolling at her 10, 12 at a time. They walk right to the elections building downstairs in Ventura County, and I followed them, and they were signing up to vote the day they turned 18 years old. And they're not signing up to vote for Donald Trump. Let's put it that way. Although Fuentes was charged only with actions that appear on the videotape and involved just a handful of ballots, investigators believe the effort went much, much further, and it did. Attorney General's Office Investigator William Clough wrote in one report that there was some evidence suggesting Fuentes actively canvassed San Luis neighborhoods and collected ballots, in some cases, paying for them, which is highly illegal, and that lady in Wisconsin, well, she's a New York socialite, she paid for the votes for Al Gore in 2000 against George W. Bush, and she paid them through cigarettes, and there was some cash. They couldn't prove the cash. She was a bleach blonde, 400-pound socialite that got a slap on the wrist by, you know, the Democrats in office. If you're a Republican, you go to jail. If you're a Democrat, you get off. See my video about the Michael Sussman trial. Collecting ballots in that manner was a common get-out-the-vote tactic used by both political parties before Arizona passed the 2016 law. Not true. Associated Press, you got this one wrong. It was mostly done by the Democrats, and it started with Bill Clinton in 1992. Get it right. The Democrats are ones who are bitching up and get out the vote because it favors them. Paying for ballots has never been legal. Oh, gee, you think? There is no sign she or anyone else in Yuma County collected ballots in a general election, but investigators from the Attorney General's office are still active in the community. The Arizona Republic reported Tuesday that the search warrants were served last month at a nonprofit in San Luis. The group's executive director is chair of the Yuma County Board of Supervisors and said the warrant sought the cell phone of a San Luis councilwoman who may have been involved in illegal ballot collection. At a legislative hearing Tuesday where election conspiracy theorists testified, the Yuma primary election case was again a highlight. Quote, it's all about corruption in San Luis and the skewing a city council election, Yuma Republican Representative Tim Dunn said. This has been going on for a long time, that you can't have free and fair elections in South County for decades, and it's spreading across the country. End of quote. And that's right. The guy was right when he said that. So, my conclusion, this mirrors the Lorna Sanchez stealing that election for the redistricting of the 26th Orange County, California, Garden Grove, and she beat Bomber Dornan by less than 1,000 votes. There was several recounts, and the first recount, Bob Dornan, well, he lost by 997 votes. He picked up 5 votes the first count, 5 more votes the second count, 5 more votes the third count. Well, he kept picking up votes, and then there were people that were withdrawing their votes, something that people don't know about. In the old rules, in the old days, before they started changing everything, to win elections forevermore in this country, you could go up and say, hey, you know, I really shouldn't have voted. I didn't know you had to be a citizen. Votes have a control number on it. You can pull the vote back. So that's what happened here. Some of the people got spooked by this because it made the news that there was going to be a recount. And Richard Gephardt was a Democrat senator leader. The Senate, like Chuck Schumer is now, wields a lot of power. And said, well, we're going to give Sanchez a seat anyway. While they took 13 months to decide, yeah, we found some illegals voting, but not enough to overturn an election. But what they're not telling you is, they stopped counting the old Immigration Naturalization Service, INS, before they changed the name. When something bad happens, you move from the old house, like Johnny Cochran moved from his house in New York, he moved across the country, he moved somewhere else, and the O.J. Simpson trial was over. And when something bad happens, you change the name, get a new LLC, bury the old vibe, or whatever you want to call it, get a new name, start over, okay? So the INS changed its name to ICE. That's how it got changed, by the way, folks. So study your history, open up a book. OK, okay? There was one House rep, Mr. Micah from Florida. He's the only one who voted for not to seat Loretta Sanchez. But the other eight members, nine members voted on it. It was 8-1, and they decided to seat Loretta Sanchez, give her that illegal seat. But they stopped counting, okay, the immigration board stopped counting 10% of the ballots. They uncovered 746 documented, tallied, illegal aliens voting in that election. And it's on the congressional site. That's part of my evidence. It's still up to date as far as I know. And I'll get it again, okay? It's on the congressional record. It's in Congress. They cannot wipe this away. They can't call me a liar because I'm going to prove it. I proved it once on YouTube years ago and prove it again. But they stopped counting it at 10%. And that order was given by Richard Gephardt, okay? And then when they went over Gephardt's head, then it went to Janet Reno, the Attorney General of the United States, the Democrat under Bill Clinton, who said, Cedar, stop the counts. That's what happened. That's how Loretta Sanchez got that seat. And she got in her office for two, three, four terms. She changed her married name from Brixley to her maiden name, Sanchez, or surname Sanchez, and got the Latinos to vote for her. The guy's assistant panicked so much when they were having the investigation, he fled to Mexico. Never be seen again. He went in the mountains. He went in hiding. So why would you go do that if you weren't doing anything wrong? That video's going to come back up if I still have it. I have to rework it, redo it. But the evidence is there for the world to see. The Democrats have been cheating in elections forever. The first 100 cases came for my VEX company, Voter Election Case Studies. 88% were the Democrats cheating, 11% Republicans cheating, 1% independents, and one of them was a dog catcher's race. At a dog catcher's race, people were freaking cheating for a dog animal control dog catcher's race. Dog catcher's race. I want to say it again so it gets you your thick skulls. Dog catcher race. There was voter fraud. There was cheating in a voter fraud case for dog catcher. Don't tell me people don't cheat. Don't tell me they're still not cheating. They are. Oh, Donald Trump is lying. No, Donald Trump was not lying. He warned us they were going to do this. But then again, Donald Trump refused to bring the military in to stop all this stuff with the machines. Donald Trump could have brought the military in. Nixon threatened to do this too, by the way. Gathered all the ballots. And then one by one, hey, go on to a house that doesn't exist. Who is this person? Go get that person, arrest that person. Voter fraud. If it's illegal, deport them. See, and that's what they don't want. They don't want the workers in their fields, whatever they're working at or not working, the illegal aliens in this country, they don't want them deported. They're part of the economy. Oh, we need them for the economy. They don't stop and think that if your business is hurting that bad, you got to be committing crimes to do this and destroy our country. Maybe you need to get into a different business. I have an eBay business. If it wasn't profitable, I'd get another business. I'd start another business. My father told me something. I'm going to say it right now in front of YouTube. You all can just kiss my you-know-what, okay? I don't care who doesn't like this. My father told me, he said, you show me an easy business and we'll go out tomorrow and start it. No such thing as an easy business anywhere in the world. No such thing as an easy business. Every business is hard. Every business is tough. That's life. Get with the program. Accept it and move on and do your best. But they can't do that. They have to cheat. That's the only way they stay in power. Now they've destroyed the country. They would rather burn the country to the ground, risk civil war, risk everything, risk Russia nuking us, a country that got 6,000 nuclear warheads, more than all the other, more than 800 countries combined. Yeah, just keep pushing Putin. Good idea, Joe Biden. Keep calling him names. Keep telling him you're going to bitch slap him. Yeah, go ahead, tough guy. Joe Biden, I got news for you. That's not corn pop over there. Okay, that guy's destroy your ass. I'd love to see Joe Biden and Vladimir Putin get in the ring. Even Joe Biden's like a foot taller. But I would bet on Putin in a minute, trust me. It'd be like Mike Tyson knocking down that big dead guy that was 6'6", wherever it is. He was a whole foot head tall, Mike Tyson. And for one round, Mike Tyson got him. Because he's a fighter, and Putin's a fighter. People forget that. But I've said enough. Don't tell me that this voter fraud doesn't exist. It exists. You just don't want to admit it. And when you're caught in the corner, pull a James Comey, and you pull a Hillary Clinton, you pull that big fat turd, that New York congressman, Jerry Nadler. What's Antifa? What's that? What? You just outright lie and deny it to their face, look them right in the eye, and you sleep with babies at night because you're pure evil.
There's violence across the whole country. Do you disavow the violence from Antifa that's happening in Portland right now?
That's a myth that's being spread only in Washington, D.C.
About Antifa in Portland?
Yes.
Sure, there's videos everywhere online. There's fires and riots. They're throwing fireworks at federal officers. DHS is there. Look online. It gets crazy, Mr. Nadler.
There's one way to deal with evil, and I know the answer. Stay tuned for my next video. Hope this video finds you well. Always great day to be an American. Thank you. Have a good day.